future occurrence. So I want to look at personal security measures. We've discussed about physical security measures. We want to look at personal security measures. At this point in time, I want to tell every one of us that our security is very, very important. And we are the number one security officers for ourselves. You are the number one security officer of yourself. So security issue is a do-it affair. Do-it-yourself affair. It's all right. So what are the personal security measures that must be in place? Number one, we need to know that security is everyone's responsibilities. Your personal security is very critical to you first and foremost. Before you can talk about someone not doing his work well as a security officer, one should audit his or herself too. So your personal security is a very critical to you first, and that's the foremost thing. Then as an employee, you are expected to have your own security plan. You are expected to have your own security plan as an employee. I remember some years back, I worked with Nigerian Gas Company at the Tama Station, just by the Tama Station there. And most times, whenever I'm on duty, what I always, there is a particular spot because our fence is transparent. The place is fenced with barbed wire. Then, I don't know the situation of things now. And I will just have this thought within me. In case of any fire accident, there is a spot I just located within me that I will use as my escape route. So everyone, as an employee, you are to have your own security plan. Okay. So what are the tips that will assist us in formulating our own security plan? Number one, we must understand the possible threat in the work. The possible threat in the work environment, we must know it. We must ask questions where in doubt. Excuse me. So we must know the threat that surrounds our work environment. And of course, in the case of the company I cited that I work with, we deal in gas, and I know that, God forbid, any explosion, a lot of damages will be done. So, and whenever there is any doubt, one should ask questions. Number two, we must develop a sense of security awareness. Do not take security for granted. Don't take security for granted. Be sure and have a sense of security awareness. Then we must avoid routine patterns of activity as much as possible. Dynamism is one of the things that life requires. We must look for a way to change the way we do things as much as possible. Not doing the same thing almost every time, not walking the same road or every time. Most times when I'm walking on the road, I'm sensitive to people coming behind me. And of course, it's not that advisable to walk the road while you back the upcoming vehicle. These are tips we all need to have in our mind as we walk. So I'm always sensitive to people moving around me. And whenever I'm driving, I'm always very sensitive to cars coming around me, especially when I'm going on a far distance. At times I try to look at the plate number if I suspect. And of course, my suspicion might not also be very right, but at least it's one of the consciousness of security awareness. Then we must protect our personal information. There are a lot of people, they divulge their personal information on social media. A lot of people don't know how to really protect their personal information. I got a write-up somewhere, and someone said that the phone number you use for your BVN if not well kept, such phone number can be used to trace your BVN number or the one you use in during your bank account registration. So all these are information that must be kept very, very well. Must be kept very well. On social media, especially Facebook, I've seen people, they call it a baby shower. I don't know whether I'm right. I think they call it baby shower. I don't know. Is that what they call it? Can someone just help me in the chat room and type 11 if that's what they call it? Where you see pregnant women, they expose their belly to show that they are pregnant. These are one of the pills we have in the world. Okay, thank you. Yeah, that's it. So I'm of opinion that such things in those days should be kept. But all these are information that are not meant for outsiders. And of course, talking about protecting personal information, some people don't even know how to keep their immediate boss phone number. They give it anyhow. They give their contact to anyhow as they like. All these are not too good for us as a security expert. Then, okay. That we need to adopt realistic security measures. Adopt realistic security measures. Of course, we need to have contingent security plan. Then we need to avoid self-targeting. Then we need to avoid unnecessary exposures to risk. I remember, I don't know, I just want to say this. I'm sorry to be referring to myself every time. There was a time I had a wedding to conduct in Ekuma, precisely, in Edo State. And I have to leave the damn camp as early, that was on Saturday morning. And after VG, I drove all the way to Ekuma very early in the morning. And I was trying to catch up with the timing. And you know what? On the road, I discovered the brake of my vehicle got failed because someone said, can I be a little louder? Okay. Please, can you hear me loud and clear? If you can hear me loud and very clear, please type 11 in the chat room. Mr. Shola or Mrs. Shola Fagbon, can you hear me? Please, if you can hear me, I need feedback. Thank you, Director Mike. Is there another person that can hear me clearly? I think it's only, okay, it's better now. All right, thank you. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. All right. So because I wanted to meet up with the programs, so I ran into a ditch and the brake of the car got issues. And because I never wanted to raise panic to people I have in the car with me, I didn't tell anybody anything, and I managed until we got to, of course, very, very bad, and is not advisable. So we should avoid unnecessary exposures to risk. We should avoid exposing ourselves to risk, okay? Then we should understand and obey security rules and regulations of the company. Part of the tips to assist us in formulating our own security plan, we should understand and obey the security rules and regulations of the company. Then we want to look at personal security concerns in the office. In the office. All doors leading to the office must be properly locked and keys handed down in this designated place when closing or leaving the office. All doors must be closed, must be locked, and key handed over to whoever needs to have them before leaving the office. In other words, office doors shouldn't be left ajar after close. All appliances must be properly switched off before leaving the office. Appliances, the sockets on the wall must be switched off. In a computer network, access to strategic information should only be granted to authorized users. For example, production data. All these are very sensitive information that no one should access except people that are authorized to do so. Sensitive information should not be published on company website to avoid information tapping. There are some information that should not be on the website. Something happened a few months ago. Internal memo was of the organization I work with was discovered on social media. And thank God for technology. The source through which such thing got exposed was traced. So there's some sensitive information that should not be published on company's website or should not be published for the general populace, all right? So computer usage in the network system must be passworded to restrict login. Computer usage in the network system must be passworded to restrict login. Unwanted documents should be well destroyed, if possible, through shredding. Unwanted documents should be destroyed. And of course, restrict companies' discussions to limited areas. Company discussions shouldn't be had everywhere, and everybody shouldn't have access to hearing some things about the organization we work with. So there are some discussions that should be restricted to office. Some discussion should be restricted to within the managers or within the workforce. Okay. 40 doors and windows should be reported promptly and follow up immediately. 40 doors and windows should be reported promptly and follow up immediately. Okay. Then we must avoid leaving visitors alone in the office, especially when there is money in your drawer. Visitors must not be allowed alone in the office. Well, especially when there is money in the drawer. And some cases also, if there is no money in the drawer, visitors should also still not be left alone in the office. Some people don't know this, that you shouldn't sit in someone's office if that person is not there. So office should not be left alone for visitors to sit or to stay. Okay. Then do not leave workmen, cleaners, workers, etc. alone in the office. Workmen, cleaners should not be left alone in the office. Okay. Avoid keeping shared keys under footmat or other known places. Keys should not be put in a known place. So just avoid keeping such keys in a known places. All right. We should also avoid monetary transaction, especially cash payment in the office. Cash payment as much as possible should be avoided in the office. So cash transaction can be done in the bank, can be deposited and teller be brought to the office. Because if a monetary transaction goes on in the office, it can attract people, especially thieves, to come and visit such office, okay? And of course, they can also tempt people walking around. Anybody can go open a drawer and pick some certain amount. Then what are the personal security concerns we must consider in our various homes? And of course, we need to say something here, that personal security is not applied to work places alone. Is also applicable to our homes. So what's the number one? Number one, we need not to live alone. Okay, there's a case of murdered pilot in Lagos a few years back. We need not to live alone. There are several cases in the media you can read about someone living alone, and then somebody come, they murder the person, and for 2-3 days, people didn't discover that such person is dead. So let's try as much as possible not to live alone, okay? Then if you must need house help, ensure that you demand for usual photographs, written application with both your signature and fingerprints, and must provide guarantors. And he must not harbor strangers in the house. So these are other tips that will be very useful for us in our various homes. When you are living and you need an house help, make sure your house help is someone that you can trace, okay? Then we should also ensure security light be switched on off from within the house. Security light should be switched on within the house. Yes. Security light within the perimeters of the house or the compound should have a switch within from the house and off and on. And of course, at night, it's advisable that the security lights be put on. Then remove all or any object that can assist an intruder to gain entrance into your house, like ladder. Ladder shouldn't be put very close to the fence outside or within. So any object that can assist intruder from gaining entrance into the house should be removed. Very often, ladders are left on the fence wall. In some places, people leave ladder on the fence wall. This is not too good. Okay. Demand for ID card from anybody claiming to be from Waterworks, PHCN, as we have it now, IBDC, or then Discos, okay, then NITEL, etc. From any and every service agent, whoever comes in to see us, ID card should be demanded for. And as a matter of fact, I should also say this, that we also have rights to demand for any policeman ID card that is not wearing uniform. Because anyone could come to you and stop you, but you have the right to also request for such a person's ID card if such a man or woman is not wearing uniform. Okay? Then outside our home, in public, what do we need to do to have our own security system? Number one, money shouldn't be counted openly. Money should not be counted openly. I've seen people doing that several times. It's not too advisable, especially when you are in a public bus. Such should be avoided. When such is done, you attract people to you. And people that shouldn't be attracted to you also will be attracted by that singular act. Then do not patronize strange women or men. They could be agents of robbers or ritual killers. When traveling, ensure that valuables are close by. As a matter of fact, within reach. When traveling, make sure your valuable goods are close by you. It is very also important that you should seriously observe the look and movement of the occupant of a bus or taxi before entering. It's very important that you seriously observe the look and movement of the occupant of a bus or taxi before entering. Then we should dump the habit of eating from people you don't know. Let's transmit as possible. So for those that are doing this, it's not a very good habit. Then avoid going alone, especially in the night, if possible. Avoid moving alone, especially in the night, if possible. Okay, try to vary the timing and route home. Do not create a regular pattern of behavior that enables an attacker to know your movement and, to know your movement. Okay. So what number seven is saying is this: we should try as much as possible to avoid having a regular pattern of movement or behavior. Time will not permit me to tell us. I will call it a story, but let me quickly. Then we have site security plan. Then number one, security survey. The security department staff should do this prior to mobilization to site. The site should be secured. The security departmental staff should have gone around the site before mobilization to site. The objective is to identify all the possible security risks. Then we have risk assessment. The security risk assessment is important to evaluate likelihood and rank consequences of incidents. The security risk assessment is important to evaluate the likelihood and rank consequence of incident. So, security, this will evolve as a solution to the outcome of the risk assessment. However, the following are the major elements of good security plan. Number one, Deterrent measures. Deterrent measures. This measure entails placing an obstacle or security barrier to support security operatives if defense is light. There should be a measure that can deter that won't give free access into, there will be an obstacle, yes. That won't give free access into the site. Number two, electronic measures where impossible. These measures, where possible, these measures require electronic gadgets such as CCTV, burglary alarm, metal alarm, fire alarm, etc., being installed at strategic points to aid security operatives. All these gadgets are useful. It helps security personnel department. Then access control measures, as discussed earlier under physical security. Access control measures, that has to do with gates, as we earlier discussed. Then staff protection. This is a very crucial function of the security department. To ensure staff protection, stranger or visitor shouldn't be allowed to wait in the office before the arrival of a staff. Then information about staff movement must be made secret. Information about staff movement must be made secret, okay? Workers working late or working on weekends are normally registered with the security department. Cameras are usually not allowed into installation and premises except for official use. Then want to look at investigation and review. Review of plan in one place should be carried out as much as the need arises. This could be as a result of new risk identified, new technologies and concept in security, or an occurrence of incidents. When investigations are carried out, review must be done in order to identify risk. And when risk are identified, there should be plans to get rid of such risk. Then in case of new technologies, of course, a review of our security system must also be done. And in case of occurrence incidents, if something keep happening, then security department should or must be reviewed. Okay, not be reviewed, okay. Want to look at, okay, security, site security and procedure. The rules for success in any site. The rules of success in any site security. ER procedure is preparedness. The rule for success in any site security ER procedure is preparedness. So there must be preparedness. Everybody must be prepared. Okay. ER assumes that all potential risks have been assessed and have been put in place. ER assumes that all potential risks have been assessed and plan have been put in place. It's also important to know that to know what your role is in case of any emergency. Okay, report immediately in case of any emergency. It could be a chain reaction. Then call the police, then be your brother's keeper. Also, what are the responsibilities of the security department? The security unit of company. Number one, they are to protect company's personnel, assets, and information from damage, theft, or loss. Security department must protect company's personnel. They must protect company's assets and information from damage, from theft, or loss. Then number two, we have provision of prompt and effective response to any criminal or security incident or other fire security related emergency, which may be detrimental to company's interest. Okay, prompt security to effectiveness, to effective response to any issues that arise. That's one of the responsibilities of security department. Number three, identification of immediate and possible threat to the company and asset. And such must be reports. Such reports should be made to divisional management. OK, identification of immediate and possible threat to the company and asset, and report such intelligence report to divisional management. Okay. Then conducting investigation on criminals and security incidents and submitting such reports or recommendations to management. All right. So investigation must be conducted, and then of course report must also be, and recommendation must be written to the manager. Issuing and controlling the use of company ID card to authorize persons to effective access into company. All these are responsibility of security department. Provision of security advice to both staff and management. Then lastly, with government law enforcement agents like the police and the rest of them, they carrying out executive protection and escort duties. Security also, they involve themselves in carrying out executive protection and escort duties, okay? Then understand foot mobile patrol duties. They must also understand foot mobile and patrol duties, as we said earlier. Then checking and controlling human and vehicle traffic in and out of the company. Checking and controlling human and vehicle traffic in and out of the company. Screening for suspicious objects at the airport and helipad before boarding the aircraft or helicopter. These are duties of a security and department. So, on this note, I just have a few questions that we just need to possibly type answers in the chat room, because we are going straight to the next lecture. Go straight to the next lecture, talking about journey management, all right? So the first question is, the first question here is, what is security, okay? And what's the difference between security and safety? What is the difference between security and safety? Okay, can someone just give me a feedback from the chat room? What's the difference between security and safety? Then list and explain the physical security measures you know. Just pick any of these questions and give me an answer from the chat room.